Hello students, in this video I will explain line by line part 2 of chapter 2 from your book Flamingo, Lost Spring, authored by Anish Jung. As in part 1 we studied about a boy named Sahib, his family's occupation was rag picking. He belonged to a very poor class family. His childhood was not as happy as the common children we see or as children are expected, because spring season is the symbol of childhood is a symbol of spring season. But Sahib was not able to enjoy his childhood, and in the age of playing and going to school and learning something, he was forced to pick rags. Later on, he found that he joined a tea stall, tea booth, and he started working there. So author is discussing in this chapter basically about the deprived class people and their sufferings and how they are deprived from the facilities of their lives even in their childhood. In the second part of the chapter, actually this is the third video, but we are in the second part of the chapter. It is again related to a boy named Mukesh. He's also he also belongs from a deprived community. I want to drive a car. As part one of this chapter has you can say title that sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. Similarly, I understood that why this statement was introduced by the author, pick the central idea of that part one. In the part second, we'll find that I want to drive a car. This is it. Maybe you can say that it is the title of part two. So we'll get later on that why this statement has been focused by the author. Let's start language explanation of part 2. Mukesh insists on being his own master. I will be a motor mechanic, he announces. Now author is face to face with another child named Mukesh, because as you know that her habit was to move among the people, and especially to talk about the deprived class people and to know their problems. In that sequence, he met a boy named Mukesh, and we'll know the story that where from this story belongs. So Mukesh insists, means he sees again and again, his statement has a force on being his own master. And Mukesh wanted to be his own master. He wanted to do something of his own. He doesn't want to do something traditional or something any other work of others. He wanted to be his own master. He wanted to do some own job. I will be a motor mechanic. He says that I will be a motor mechanic, he announces, he spoke. Do you know anything about cars, I ask. Then author asks, if you want to be a motor mechanic, do you know anything about cars? I will learn to drive a car. Then he says that yes, I don't know right now about cars, but I will learn to drive a car, because if you will become a motor mechanic, not only he will have to repair those vehicles or cars or anything of which he will become the motor mechanic, he must know how to drive it also. He answers the question of author. Well, author asks, do you know anything about cars? He says, I will learn to drive a car. Looking straight into my eyes, and while he spoke this statement, I will learn to drive a car, he was looking straight into the eyes of author while he answered. It means he was in full confidence. But according to author, to see the condition of this child, author is quite doubtful that either he will be able to realize his dream or not. His dream looms like a mirage. Here author says that his dreams looms means appears, looks like a mirage. Mirage is basically an optical illusion caused by atmospheric conditions, especially the appearance of sheet of water in a desert or a hot road caused by the reflection of light from the sky by heated air. It means a kind of illusion, a kind of impossibility, mirage, a kind of impossibility. So his dream was just appearing impossible amid dust. Why? Because amid dust, the dust of his streets, because in the area in the surrounding Mukesh was living, that area was full of dust, the streets were full of dust that filled his town Firozabad. This child Mukesh belongs to Firozabad, and the roads of Firozabad, house where he was living, his family members were living, that was a very dirty area, and living in so poor condition, Even to be a motor mechanic was impossible. That's why his dream was appearing just impossible for him. Famous for its bangles, and Firozabad is very famous for making bangles. Every other family in Firozabad, every second family is engaged in making bangles, is doing the same job making bangles. It is the center of India's glass blowing industry, and it is the main center of India's glass blowing, means where the glass is blown, means the glass has been, you can say, melted on hot temperature. Glass blowing industry, you can say in collectively, these three words saying glass blowing industry is bangle making industry. So it is the chief center of India's bangle making industry, where families have spent generations were around working around furnaces, where families have spent their generations and generations around furnaces. Furnaces are used to melt the glasses, welding glasses, that means to turn the glasses to give the glass to shape of a bangle circular. Making bangles for all the women in the land, it seems. And if you will visit Firozabad and you will see the people engaged in bangle making with so much intensity, you will think that this is basically, perhaps this is the place where these people are not making bangles for India, perhaps they are making bangles for all over the world. So they work so with so much intensity. Mukesh family is among them. Mukesh family was also one of the family of sustainable families who were engaged in bangle making. None of them know it is illegal for children like him to work in the glass furnaces with high temperatures. But none of the family's parents were not aware that it is illegal. It is against law for a children like him, like Mukesh was a child, to work in the glass furnaces, to work in the furnaces with high temperatures. Furnaces were used to melt the glasses when the glasses were high temperatures. And it was totally illegal to allow to a child of Mukesh's age to work around these high temperature furnaces, because it may cause a lot of health problems. In dingy cells, means in dirty cells, small houses, small, you can say, workshops where bangles were made, without air and light, there was no proper ventilation, there was no proper light, that the law, if enforced, that the law says it is against law to allow to children to work in these kind of conditions. Actually, children are not allowed to work in any condition, but in these conditions especially, it is very dangerous for them. If enforced, if law is enforced, then it will not be possible. Could get him and all those 20,000 children out of the hot furnaces, wherever they slog their daylight hours, often losing the brightness of their eyes. Author says here that if law is enforced here, if law, according to law, we will think, could get him and all those, not only Mukesh, but all the 20,000 children, approximately 20,000 children in Firozabad work they are busy in bangle making industry along with their family members, their parents. They all will come out of those hard furnaces where they slog, means they use their daylight hours. In daytime they work there, often losing the brightness of their eyes, and most of the time these children lost their eyesight also because of these dirty conditions and high temperature of furnace. Mukesh's eyes beam. All of a sudden there was a smile in Mukesh's eyes. Why there was a smile in Mukesh's eyes? Beam means smile. As he volunteer means he self wished to take me home. As author met Mukesh was very interested. Mukesh was very interesting to take author to his home. And while he told author that would you come to come with me to my house, there were a smile in his eyes. He was very happy to take author to his home, which he proudly says, there was a smile in his eyes, because he proudly says to author, is being rebuilt, that my house is rebuilt. There was so poor condition that his house was rebuilt, it was repaired, and he was very happy. He wanted author to see his house, because making houses were very difficult in those days there. We walked down stinking lanes. Now author is going along with Mukesh to his house, and they are walking through stinking lanes. The lanes means pathways which they are going. They are stinking, very dirty, chalked with garbage everywhere. Chalked, that means you can say almost full of garbage, past homes that remained hovels. And on the way, author saw many homes, crossed homes, that remained hovels, means looking just like those homes were not homes, they were just hovels, means hut, you can say a kind of a very poor condition houses, you can say jhopadi, that is hovels, with crumbling walls. The walls of all those houses were very old and damaged. Oblique doors, old doors, damaged doors, broken doors, no windows. There was no windows in those houses. You can imagine that if there were no windows in the house, then how, what was the ventilation and light condition? Crowded with families. All the houses were crowded with families, means a lot of people are living, means in those houses people are living beyond its capacity of humans and animals coexisting. And in those houses, small houses, human being also and animals were also, they had kept animals like cow and buffaloes like these and goats and others. Those animals were also coexisting ones together with they were living, animals and human being living in the same house together with in a primal stage. Primal stage, that means as in ancient time, in stone age, we could see the people were uncultured and they used to live in the same way, that is primal. So as we have found in ancient, we have studied in ancient India, in a stone age India, similar condition was there of these families. They were living animals and human being together with. He stops at one, at the door of one such house. Similar houses, one such house means very poor condition houses, author saw on the way. And in front of same house, one of the houses, Mukesh stopped, bangs an oblique iron door, which he told that his house is repaired actually, but that is still very poor condition house. Bangs means he kick with his legs to the door of oblique door, that old door, but door was iron made, iron door of his house. This is the house of Mukesh, and this is the oblique iron door of Mukesh's house door. With his foot, he kicked his door with his foot to open it and pushes it open, and then he pushed it by his hands to open it. We entered a half-built shack, author says, that we entered a half-built shack. Shack, you know, that is a kind of container. So that was a very small house, and that house was still half-built, but Mukesh was so proud that it is rebuilt. So poor condition was of the Pirozwat families. In one part of it, in one part of that house, thatched with dead grass, that means the roof was made of dead grass, is a firewood stove. At one corner of the house, there was a firewood stove, means for cooking food, there was a stove was used, over which sits a large vessel. On that stove, a large vessel, a very big dish was kept, pot was kept, of sizzling, that means you can boiling. Spinach means a kind of, you can say a kind of vegetable, is a palak, that is leaves, spinach leaves were sizzling, boiling on a big pot that was kept on a stove. On the ground, other side, in a large aluminium platter, in a large aluminium made platter, you can say a big kind of container in which we weed flour. This may atta gutte, that is platter. So in that platter are more chopped vegetables. Chopped means cut. More cut vegetables were kept. Spinach were there in the big pot on the stove, and more cut vegetables were kept on the large platter. A frail young woman, a very weak looking, lean and thin, young age but very lean and thin, very weak looking lady is cooking the evening meal. That she was cooking the evening meal for the whole family. That was evening time, so she was cooking the evening meal for the whole family. Through eyes filled with smoke, she smiles because of stove smoke which entered into her eyes. She smiled to see the author with the smoke in her eyes. She is the wife of, who is this young lady? She is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother. She is wife of Mukesh's elder brother, not much older in years. She was not much older in years, still young. She has begun to command respect as the Bahu. But she has become the Bahu, as you can say, the daughter-in-law. The daughter-in-law of the house. She was the daughter-in-law of the house, already in charge of three men. Already she was taking the responsibility in so young age of three men, her husband. Who were these three people? Her husband, Mukesh, and their father, means her father-in-law. When here in these lines, actually, the poet is commenting about the child marriage system. When the older man enters, means when the father, older man, the father of Mukesh enters in the house, she gently withdraws behind the broken wall. This lady, Bahu, was cooking food. And when the older man, her father-in-law came, Mukesh's father came, at the same time he entered in the house. The older man came, she gently withdraws behind the broken. She tried to, this lady, Bahu, tried to hide herself behind, there was a wall, broken wall, and brings her veil closer to her face. And she covered her face with a broken, withdraws his closer to her face. Well, you know, veil is a kind of face cover, khungar, that is, closer to her face. As custom demands, because it is the demand of custom, daughter-in-laws must veil, that daughter-in-laws must cover their face before male elders, before the, when the elders of the family come in front of her. In this case, the elder is an impoverished bangle maker. In this case here, the elder person is an impoverished, means poor, bangle maker. Despite long years of hard labor, this elder, means Mukesh's father, is called here impoverished, poor bangle maker. Actually, it is not the fault of Mukesh's father that he was poor. Despite long years of hard labor, means Mukesh's father had worked for so many years in making bangles so hard. First as a tailor, first Mukesh's father started his career as a tailor, then a bangle maker, then he started making bangles. He has failed to renovate, but even after doing so many things, he failed to renovate, means repair, even his house. It was a different matter to build a house. It was a far more matter to build a house. He was even failed to repair his house. Send his two sons to school. He was even failed to send his two sons to school. Mukesh and his elder brother was not even went to school also. All he has managed to do is teach them what he knows. All this old man did for his sons was only that he teach them what he knows. And what he knows? The art of making bangles. This old man only knew one art, that is the art of making bangles, and that he taught to his children also, Mukesh and his elder brother. It is his karma, his destiny, says Mukesh's grandmother. It is his karma, his means here Mukesh's grandfather. He says that his destiny, says Mukesh's grandmother. Mukesh's grandmother was also there. Mukesh's grandmother says that it is the karma of destiny, that is, it is the luck of, it is our bad luck. It is especially the bad luck of Mukesh's grandfather, who has washed her own husband, who has washed, means Mukesh's grandmother has washed her own husband, Mukesh's grandfather, go blind. He became blind with the dust from the polishing the glass of bangles. Means when bangles are made, the glass needs to be polished for making it shining and making it good looking bangles. So while it is polished, a lot of dust come out in the form of glass. And because of that dust, Mukesh's grandfather has become blind. So she has seen her husband goes blind, Mukesh's grandmother goes blind in front of his eyes. That's why she is cursing actually their destiny, their life, that it is the karma. Can a God-given lineage, now she is again cursing, Mukesh's grandmother says, can a God-given lineage means a kind of business, a kind of thing which is being continued from generations and generations. He says that it is a God-given lineage, it's a God-given hierarchical problem to us. Ever we broken? That is bangle making. That's God has given us a kind in our luck, in our fate, poverty, and this bangle making process, work, but we are not getting benefited by this work. And she hopes that will a time come in their life when this problem will be ended. She implies, she spoke. Born in the caste of bangle makers, she further told Mukesh's grandmother that born in the caste of bangle makers, they have seen nothing but bangles. They have seen nothing but bangles in the house, the bangles in the yard, there were bangles in every other house, in every other the bangles. Means most of the families are engaged in bangle making. Every other yard means every house have other yards. In whole Firozabad, you can find bangles. A spiral of bangles means, spiral, you know that as bangles are found in circular shape. So it's a collection of bangles, sunny gold. These are the colors of bangles. Sunny golden color, paddy green color, royal blue color, pink color, purple color. Every color born out of the seven colors of the rainbow. Means whatever the color we can expect in rainbow, every color bangle is made by these bangle making families. Line mounts in unkept yards, and these bangles of different colors are lies. You can find lie means kept, mounts means in a heap, in unkempt yards means uncleaned yards, houses. You could find a lot of bangles everywhere. Are piled on four-wheeled hand carts. You can find these bangles also kept in It is kept in unkept yards, means unclean, dirty houses are piled on four-wheeled hand carts, and that is kept on four-wheeled hand carts also for selling purpose. Pushed by young men, and these four-wheeled hand carts to keep bangles on it, the young men push it along the narrow lanes of Shanty Town. Shanty Town means that slum area. Poor people, where Shanty Town is the kind of area where poor people live. So in the sandy town, in this poor town, Firozabad, people move on their four-wheeled carts to sell the their bangles. And in dark hutmates, their houses were dark all the time. Even in daytime, it was dark, not sufficient light. Next to lines of lamps of flickering oil lamps, means next you can find that it, in evening, because it was evening time while author went to Mukesh's house. Now the oil lamps has been lighted by all the houses and flickering. The illumination and the light of the oil lamps were seen. Seat boys and girls, and even the oil lamp, seat boys and girls, see author observed that boys and girls with their fathers and mothers were sitting along with their fathers and mothers, welding pieces of colored glass. They were folding the pieces of colored glasses and making bangles into circular bangles, into the circular shape of, they were giving the circular shape of bangles to the glass. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark than to the light outside. Their eyes are more adjusted to the dark inside their houses rather than the light outside. Means they had not enjoyed their life. This phrase says that these children had not enjoyed their child days. They didn't get any opportunity to enjoy their child days, and they were accustomed to work in their dark houses. That is why they often end up in losing their eyesight before they become adults. And because they were accustomed to work in darkness, you can imagine that if you will work in a dark area, often you may have a danger to lose your eyesight. And similarly, these children lose their eyesight even before they become adult. Savita, a young girl. Now author is actually you know that author is on the visit of Firozabad, and she has gone to Mukesh's house on the request of Mukesh. And in his same, in the area of Mukesh's house, now she is visiting another house, and where she found a girl named Savita in a drab pink dress. She was wearing a drab old pink dress. This girl Savita, she was also a small girl, sits alongside an elderly woman. She was sitting beside an elderly woman. Savita was sitting beside an elderly lady, perhaps maybe her grandmother, soldering pieces of glass, and she was attaching the pieces of glass and making bangles. As her hands move mechanically, and author noticed that the hands of Savita were moving mechanically, means like a machine, like the tongs of a machine, means very, you can say her hands were accustomed to make bangles, and she was working with a lot of expertness. I wonder if she knows the sanctity of the bangles she helps make. Author thought here one thing. While she saw that girl Savita, so small in age, so young in age, that the bangles which she is making, does she know the sanctity and security of these bangles, the importance of these bangles, that where these bangles are used? Actually, she does not know. Reality, she does not know that what is the use of these bangles, but she is only helping her grandmother. It symbolizes an Indian woman, Suhag. Actually, the bangles are the symbolism, the mark of the Indian woman, Suhag. That is called auspiciousness, Suhag, in marriage. In marriage, it is very useful. It has a lot of importance. It will dawn on her suddenly one day. Author thinks to see that girl Savita, who is helping her mother to make bangles. She is thinking about the daughter, that today she is making those bangles, but those bangles, it means bangles, will dawn on her. Dawn means come on that girl, her, suddenly one day, means when this girl will become aged, Savita, all of a sudden those bangles will be given to her, which she is making today, one day, when her head is dabbed with a red veil, when she will become a bride. Actually, her head will be covered with a red color veil, you can say, means she will become dulhan, you can say, that is bride. Her hands dyed red with mehndi, means when she will be get married, her hands will be dyed with henna, that is mehndi, and red bangles rolled onto her wrist, and red, she will wear red bangles, and she will become a ward of this, a lady of this world. She will then become a bride, at that time she will become a bride. Means she says that the bangles which Savita is making right now, perhaps she doesn't know the sanctity, the symbolism of those bangles, but one day she has to receive these bangles herself. Like the old woman beside her who became one many years ago. Like the old woman sitting beside this girl, means now author is talking about her grandmother, who is sitting beside her, and her grandmother has become bride many years ago. Now she has become old. Similarly, Savita today child, but in coming years she will also become a bride. Still, she still has bangles on her wrist. She means here the old lady which is sitting beside Savita, means perhaps Savita's grandmother, she still has bangles on her wrist. So this old lady is still wearing bangles on her wrist, but there is no light in her. Light means there is no hope in her eyes. Now author is talking to that old lady also. And when she talked about her situation, the lady answered, "Ek waqt sirbhar khana bhi nahi khaya." She spoke in Hindi that I have not eaten, means even after working so hard making bangles, we could not get even a time meal, time full meal. She says in a voice drained in joy. This old woman spoke in a voice that ek waqt sirbhar khana bhi nahi khaya, in a voice, in a very sad tone, drained of joy. Drained means there was no joy, that was lacking of joy, means in a sad tone. She has not enjoyed even one full meal in her entire lifetime. It is an English translation. According to that woman, while author asked, Anisam asked her, she said that she has not even enjoyed even one full meal, one time full meal in 24 hours in an entire lifetime. That's what she has reaped. That what she has reaped means she expressed her sorrow. Her husband, this old lady husband was also there. Her husband, an old woman, he was an old man with a flowing beard. His beard was long and that was flowing by air. He says, while author asks to that old man, he says, "I know nothing except bangles. I know nothing in my life except bangles. All I have done is make a house for the family to live in. All I have done in my life, and that is only," this old man says, "that all I have done in my life, that is only that I made a house for my family in which they can live." So here you could find that this old man has done something in his life as per the comparison of Mukesh's father. Mukesh's father was not able to even build his own house. Hearing him, to listen him, one wonders, anyone can surprise if he has achieved what many have failed in their lifetime. That this old man has achieved something in his life what many of his own community bangle making families were not able to achieve in their entire lifetime. What? He has roof over his head, that he has made a house over his head, and it was not very unimportant thing. It was very, very important for those bangle making families. Means they were passing their life in so poor condition that even to make a house was very difficult for them. The cry of not having money to do anything except carry on the business of making bangles, not even enough to eat, rings in every home. Now author says that the cry of not having money means the sadness of not having money means lack of money to do anything. Because of that they could start any new business except carry on the business of making bangles. Means author tried to ask that why, if this bangle making business is not profitable for you, then why don't you start the other business? They said that we don't have sufficient money to start any other business, so we are forced to make bangles. Not even enough to eat. They said that it is a difficult matter. It is a rather difficult thing to think that we should start any new business rather than making bangles. We have no money for that. We have no even sufficient money to have our food rings in every home. And this same sadness rings in every home, that you can listen in every home. The young men echo the lament of their elders. The young men also echo, means he spoke the same lament, same sadness of their elders. Means elders says that they have no money, and the young men also said that they have no money. The problem continues. Little has moved with time. Very little changes, very small changes. Means the changes which came in their life from the older generation to the new generation, that was almost unimportant, or you can say that very less. It seems in Firozabad. In Firozabad, it seems that very few changes came, very unimportant changes came. Years of mind-numbing toil, means they are working in this bangle-making industry. Many families, they have passed many years. So years of mind-numbing, numbing means blocked of toil, hard work, have killed all initiative. It has killed all their initiative, means to dare to do something new and the ability to dream. And they were not even able to dream. Means you can say that these people were working in bangle-making industries and they were making bangles. They were working so hard that and for so many years that their mind were numb, their mind become totally dull, and they were not able to do, they were not able to think even to do something new initiative, to take any new step, or they you can say in other words that they have forgot their ability to dream, to do something new. Why not organize yourself into a cooperative? I ask a group of young men who have fallen into a vicious circle of middlemen who trapped their fathers and forefathers. Author asked to a group of young men, young people. You can say that author is on the visit of Firozabad, and she went to Mukesh's house. She met there Mukesh's family. She met there a young woman, an old lady, a young girl, Savita, an old man again. Maybe that perhaps Savita's grandfather. Now she's interacting with, she's talking with another group of young people, youngsters of that place, and she's asking them that why not organize yourself a cooperative? That why don't you organize, come together with, and make a cooperative, means make a kind of association. Cooperative is a kind of association in which people gather together with, they make an unity, and they try to deposit a certain fund which may be used later on if anyone is needed. So cooperative means, she says that if a single family is not able to start a new business, then why don't you all come together with, make a cooperative, cooperate each other, then do something new, means as a whole, the whole colony or few houses together with. Author asked this question to a group of young men and people who have fallen, who have already fallen, means trapped into the vicious circle of middlemen, into a very painful circle surrounding trap of middlemen. Middlemen is the brokers who trap themselves, who have already trapped themselves, put their life in trouble, their fathers and their forefathers. Not only these young men were trapped, actually their fathers and forefathers were trapped. Middlemen actually in ancient India, you could find that in 1960s, 1970s, that poor people who they had not money, they visited to the sahukas, to the money lenders, and they borrow money from them on interest. But they were so poor that they were not able to pay their money back. They paid only interest, and many generations paid interest and interest. So this is actually the vicious circle created by the middleman. Brokers forced these families, lured these families, attracted these families to borrow money from them, from the sahukars, and sahukars lend money them on a very high interest. And once a family has taken borrowed money from these people, from a sahukar, then they are trapped into a vicious circle. They will not be able to pay that amount, and the generations and generations will pay that same amount. So the forefathers take that money from the sahukars. Fathers also paid that, and now the same loan, the same OO carries to the young men also. So a group of young men, author question that why don't you organize a cooperative? Now they are answering. This is the answer of the question. We are the ones who will be hauled up by the police. They said that if we will create a cooperative, if we will cooperate each other and try to do something new rather than bangle making, who will be hauled? Means we will be hauled, means chased by the police. Means police will also chase us, beaten. They will beat us and they will drag us to jail for doing something illegal. Why? Because policeman will say, if we'll create a cooperative, policeman will chase us, they will put us into jail because as we had done something illegal. Actually, to make a cooperative, it is not illegal, but there is a kind of, you can say, a vicious circle, that is called vicious circle of the middleman, of the sahukars, of the bureaucrats, of the police cops. The police cops also support the sahukars. And because of that, these poor people dare not to do anything new. If they dare to do something new, a few people among these families, they were tortured by the police not to do anything new. They say, there is no leader among them. Further, this group said, answer to the question, why not organize yourself into cooperative? Now they are answering that if we are daring to do something new, we are being troubled by police. Further, they said that there is no leader among us. No one would come help them see things differently. And if anyone would come us to help, he will not see the things differently. Means he will also think the similar things, that if I am going to help, suppose that someone is coming to help us to do something new, that person will also be tortured by the police. So that person also not thinks differently. He will also think that if I will help them, I will be tortured. So because of torture, no one comes to help us. Their fathers and are as tired as they are. She says, author says that their fathers, the fathers of these young children, are as tired. They are tired because they have become old, they have spent their life, they have worked for so many years, but they are also tired. They are youngest, but why they are tired? Because they have no hope in their life or progress. They talk endlessly in a spiral that moves from poverty to apathy to greed and to injustice. Author asks only one question, why not organize yourself into a cooperative? Now these young men are answering. They give many answers and they talk endlessly. Now, one by one, there was many youngsters, and one by one, all the youngsters are talking endlessly. They are sharing their problems with the author, and those problems are endless. In a spiral means one by one, they are sharing their problems. That moves means, suppose that one youngster talk about the poverty, another talk about the apathy. Apathy means the unconcerned behavior of the government and officials. That government and official also don't care about them. To greed, then they talk about the greed of the sahukars and middlemen and the police cops, and to injustice and the injustice does towards them. Listening to these young men, I see two distinct words. Author felt at once that there are two different words. One of the family, which are two words, the one word, the first word, one of the family caught in a wave of poverty. The first word of those families who are caught in a wave, in a trap of poverty, who they are being tortured by poverty, burdened by the stigma of caste. And this poverty is burdened by the stigma, means a kind of blame of caste in which they are born. Means they have born in a bangle making family, and that's why they can't do anything else. They are not even if they think, they are not allowed to do anything else. So that is called stigma, blame, kalank of caste in which they were born. This is the first word, that they were caught in poverty and in a vicious circle, and they were born in a bangle making family, so they could not do anything else. The other, a vicious circle, another is a very painful circle of the sahukars, the middlemen. These are those people who they torture these poor class people. The sahukars, the middlemen, the, you can say, brokers, the policemen also supported the sahukars, the keepers of law, the people who are responsible to implement law properly. They were also not supporting these people. The bureaucrats, the officials, you can say, and the politicians and politicians, means everyone was not supporting them. Means at one side, these poor people were there and their business was there, and at the other side, these people were there, sahukars, middlemen, policemen and keepers of law, bureaucrats and politicians were not agree to allow to have a better life to these poor people. Together they have imposed the baggage. Together means all these sahukars, middlemen, policemen, keepers of law, bureaucrats and politicians, they have imposed, they have kept the baggage, a burden on the child that he cannot put down, means baggage means that is a stigma of caste. Means even any child gets, as soon as a child gets born, birth in this bangle making family, that child is supposed to carry out the same business, and that burden is kept on his shoulder even as he came in this world, and that he cannot put down, that he cannot deny. Before he is aware, because that burden has kept on his shoulders in the child days, before he is aware, before he comes into senses and he realizes that what is he and he is having a loss, he accepts it as naturally as his father. That child also, rather than doing something new, because he was imposed that responsibility from his child days, rather than thinking to do something new, he accepts that burden as naturally as his father accepts. So he could not, even this newborn child, and while he come into senses and become adult, he could not imagine to do something new. To do anything else would mean to dare, and to do something new, to think to do something new in Firozabad rather than bangle making, if you are from a bangle making family, that is means dare, means sahukars and others will think that you are daring, you are opposing them, and daring is not part of his growing, and daring is not taught to these children from the slum, from these bangle making families. They were taught to scare, they were taught to fear, that you have to live in fear. When I sense a flash of it, that's why the line, I would like to go on the previous phase where I started today. I want to drive a car. It was spoken by Mukesh. Mukesh insists on being his own master. Mukesh says that I will not do the same business of bangle making. I will not continue that. I will be a motor mechanic. So rather be motor mechanic is also not a very, you can say, honorable job, very important job, or you can say that it is a very wonderful job. Rather than bangle making, it is similar to bangle making, but anyone was there in the bangle making family who was daring to do something new, that is a very important sign, and that may be a sign of progress also. It may set an example. When I sense a flash of it, when author sense a flash of doing something, flash means a kind of indication of it means that he will do something new. In Mukesh, I am cheered. Author was very happy. I want to be a motor mechanic. This is a flash of this is a flash that he wants to do something new. When Mukesh told that I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. Author asked Mukesh again and again, and Mukesh repeated it again and again, insisted that yes, I will be a motor mechanic. Author was very happy that someone is here who is daring to do something new. He will go on to a garage. Further, Mukesh says that I will go on to a garage and learn, and I will learn. But the garage is a long way from his home. I will walk. Author asked, but Mukesh, the garage is a long way, means it is a very long distance of a garage from your home. Then Mukesh answered, I will walk. Means he was very determined to do something new. He insists. He spoke with a lot of authority. Do you also dream of flying a plane? Author asks here that Mukesh, that do you also dream of flying a plane? Do you want to be pilot also? He's suddenly silent, but all of a sudden Mukesh becomes silent. He says no. He's staring at the ground, looking towards the ground. In his small murmur, in a very small murmuring tone, he says no. There is an embracement. He was feeling shy. He was feeling embraced that he is not dreaming of to fly a plane, that he has not yet turned into regret. But his embracement was not turned into regret. He was not regretting that he has decided to be a motor mechanic and not to fly a plane. He was happy to decide that he will be a motor mechanic. He is content to dream of cars. He was happy, satisfied to dream of cars, that he will become a motor mechanic, that he sees hurtling down the streets, that he has seen on the roads of Firozabad. Hurtling means moving, coming and going, coming of cars down the streets of his town. And Firozabad, he has seen many cars moving, and that he wanted to become a motor mechanic. Few airplanes fly over Firozabad. Few airplanes also fly over over the Firozabad, but he has not missed. He had imagined, he has a dream which was beyond his which was in his capacity. He was not dreaming something impossible. He wanted to be a motor mechanic. That was a possible dream. If he would dream to be a pilot, all of a sudden, I think he will neither be a pilot nor be a bangle maker. So he realized his capacity, potential, his family background, and that's why he, according to that, he decided. So here I finish explanation of this part. Thanks.